Engine Station on Space to Ground.
Welcome to Space to Ground. I'm Gary Jordan. NASA has a new administrator. Jim Bridenstine officially took office as the 13th administrator of NASA on Monday after he was given the oath to office by Vice President Mike Pence at the agency's headquarters in Washington. As part of the ceremony, Vice President Pence and Administrator Bridenstine spoke live with NASA astronauts Scott Tingle, Drew Feustel, and Ricky Arnold aboard the International Space Station, who offered congratulations.
A hearty congratulations to our new administrator. Congratulations on your selection to lead NASA.
I just wanted to say America loves what you guys are doing, that we are thrilled for your levels of education, your commitment to the program, your commitment to our country, and we're thrilled that you were able to join us today on this very special day. I am deeply honored, so thank you all so much.
Lots of science on board this week, but one stands out as the MVP. NASA astronaut Drew Feustel inserted food cylinders in the multi-use variable G platform, or MVP. MVP is a facility that subjects many types of samples like fruit flies, flatworms, plants, fish, cells, protein crystals, and in this case food, to artificial gravity. The platform has two internal carousels that can simultaneously produce up to 2 Gs. On Earth, we're all stuck with 1 G, no matter where we go. The International Space Station is the only research facility where gravity can be a variable long-term for experiments. This week's question comes from Kong, who wants to know what the color of the sun is from an astronaut's perspective. Without the atmosphere in the way, the sun actually appears white. Have you ever thought about how the sun is never really a consistent color? It's especially noticeable at sunset, where the sun can be yellow, orange, even sometimes a little red. This is actually shorter wavelengths of visible light, your greens, blues, and violets scattering as they pass through the atmosphere. From the space station, much of the atmosphere isn't in the way to scatter light from the sun, so the full visible spectrum comes through as a bright white. Astronauts have captured many images of the white sun from space. With 16 sunrises and sunsets per day on the space station, there are times where the astronauts can capture the sun against the horizon where light is scattered the same as a sunset on Earth, creating beautifully colored sunsets even from 250 miles above the planet. Keep sending in questions using the hashtag SpaceToGround. We'll see you next week.
Subscribe for more space.